Hi there. In my last two videos, I have introduced five different measures around distribution. Those are numeric distribution, percentage ACV distribution, percentage PCV distribution, average items carried, and total distribution points. These five measures, if you see, the first three, which is numeric, percentage ACV, and percentage PCV, are measures of the width of distribution. Average items carried is the measure of the depth of distribution, while TDP or total distribution points is the measure of the overall distribution, which takes both width and depth into consideration. If you haven't seen these videos as yet, I strongly suggest that you watch them first so that you can relate to this video much better. The focus of today's video is slightly different from the previous ones. In today's video, I am not introducing any new measures, but I will take those same measures and try and explain different kind of scenarios which you might face as a marketer. And once you really get a grasp of these different kinds of scenarios, you will be able to play with the data and arrive at a lot of important conclusions around distribution. I strongly suggest you watch the video all the way up to the end because I'll be sharing two different master sheets. What I have done is I have put together 10 different scenarios in those two master sheets, and you can use these as a reference point whenever you're confused around distribution.
The world of marketing is vast, complex, and rapidly evolving. But with just a bit of help, it can be a lot of fun. On this channel, I simplify real-world marketing for all the curious minds out there. Hi, I'm Rahul, and this is the business of marketing.
If you are new to this channel, I strongly suggest that you hit the subscribe button and also click on the bell icon so that you are notified every time I release a new video. And if you have any thoughts on this video or anything else that you would want me to cover in my future videos, please drop your messages in the comment section below. So we've seen five different measures, including TDP. And TDP is the comprehensive measure which kind of gives you an overall picture. But when you see changes in the TDP and you want to try and figure out what are the underlying causes which have led to that fluctuation in the TDP, then you need to look deeper into the other measures which are there. And that's how you go about investigating and trying to find out what really is the root cause and what is the relationship of one measure to the other when seen together. I will talk through 10 different scenarios in today's video, and using these scenarios, you can start playing Sherlock with your distribution data. But there's one thing that you really need to keep in mind before I proceed. When marketers subscribe to retail data, which is the source for all the distribution data, this retail data is only reflective of products which are sold or every time they are scanned at a particular retail outlet. If the product is not sold but merely displayed at the retail outlet, they will not reflect in the retail data. So this is something that you really need to keep in mind, that if sales have not happened, your distribution data will be affected. So let's look at the first scenario. In this scenario, we see a situation where you have very high numeric or physical distribution, but along with that, you have low percentage ACV distribution. Simply put, what this means is that your products are present in a large number of stores. However, these stores are not the biggest stores in the market. They are not the stores where the highest sales is happening. So as a result, even though it seems like your distribution is very high, the reality is that your product is not being sold in the most important stores, and therefore you need to figure out a way to get your product to be distributed in the stores which have the highest sales in that market. In the second scenario, the numeric or physical distribution stays high, but what is low is the percentage PCV distribution. So what does this mean? What this means is that your products are being sold in a large number of stores. However, these stores aren't the biggest selling stores for your category of products in the market. And therefore, you need to try and figure out which are the stores which are the best selling stores for your category of product. And when you're able to get your distribution to those kind of stores, your sales numbers will start improving. Scenario 3, This one gets a little more interesting. We see a situation where there is a high percentage ACV distribution, but at the same time, there is a low percentage PCV distribution. What does this mean? It simply means that your products are being sold in the stores which are the highest selling stores in the market. However, these same stores aren't the highest selling stores for your category of products in the market. And therefore, even though you might be present in the biggest stores in the market, these stores are probably not too relevant for your category of products, and therefore you need to try and figure out a way in which you can get your products in the stores which are important for your category. Scenario 4, it's a situation where you've got a high percentage ACV distribution, but along with it, you've got low average items carried. Now, what does this mean? What this means is that while your product is being sold in the highest selling stores in the market, but not all of your products in the product range are being sold. And therefore, if you want to improve your distribution further, you need to try and find a way in which you can get these stores to stock more of your products. I think you've started getting a hang of the kind of implications. So let's move on to the next scenario, scenario 5. In this scenario, we see a situation where there is a high percentage PCV distribution, but at the same time, you've got low average items carried. What this means is that while your product is already present in the stores which are the most important stores or the highest selling stores for your category, but at the same time, the range of products which are being sold in these stores is low. And therefore, just like the previous case, what you need to focus on is increasing the range of products that these stores are carrying. And if you're able to do that, what would happen is that you would not only be present in the stores which are most important for your category, but at the same time, these stores would be selling most of the products in your range of products which are available. Let's move on to the next scenario, scenario 6. In this scenario, we see a high percentage ACV distribution, but at the same time, we see a low numeric or physical distribution. Now, this is actually a desirable scenario. It's not a bad scenario for your brand, because what this means is that even though your products are not being sold in a large number of stores, but they are being sold in the stores which are the highest selling stores in the market. So it is actually better to have a high percentage ACV when compared to numeric or physical distribution. And scenario 7 is one where you've got high percentage PCV distribution, but along with that, you've got low physical or numeric distribution. This scenario is what I consider to be even better than the previous scenario where you had a high percentage ACV distribution over numeric distribution. Why do I say so? Because in this situation, even though your product might not be present in a large number of stores in the market, but it is already present and being sold in the stores which are the best-selling stores for your category of products. You might notice that the video's gotten a little darker. That's because it's about to start raining. So bear with me while I take you through the remaining scenarios. In the next scenario, scenario 8, we have a situation where there is high percentage PCV distribution, but at the same time, there is a low percentage ACV distribution. In most cases, this is actually a very, very good situation to be in, because what this means is that even though your product might not be present in the highest selling stores in the market, but it is being sold in the stores which are the biggest selling stores for your category of products. And therefore, given a choice between percentage PCV and percentage ACV, in most cases, the right thing to choose would be to have a better percentage PCV distribution for your products. Except in the case of products which are extremely mass market products that need to be present almost anywhere. In scenario 9, we see a situation where there is high average items carried, but with that we have low percentage ACV distribution. So what does this mean for you? To put it very simply, what this means is that the stores which are carrying your products aren't the biggest stores in the market. However, the ones which are carrying your products are carrying a very wide range of your products. Let's take a look at the last scenario, which is scenario 10. In this scenario, we have a situation where there is very high average items carried, but along with that, you've got a low percentage PCV distribution. What does this mean? Put simply, What this means is that even though the stores which are carrying your products are carrying a very wide range of the products that you have, but sadly, these aren't the highest selling stores for your category of products. And therefore, what you need to focus on here is to try and see how you can increase your distribution in the stores which are important for your category, rather than trying to negotiate with the retailers to increase the range of products that they carry for your brand. Therefore, your focus needs to be on increasing your width of distribution because the depth is pretty much doing fine. So we saw a total of 10 different scenarios. Here is the first master sheet. It has these five different kinds of scenarios, and you can always refer to this sheet whenever you are facing a situation where you're looking at these numbers and feeling a little confused. And here's the second master sheet. If you have any further questions or clarifications, you can always send them over to me. Please mention that in the comment section below. The thing to keep in mind is that this is not an exhaustive list of scenarios which are possible. These are some of the most common ones that you might encounter, and this is where your investigation to try and figure out the root cause of the issues or the root cause of why you are performing well needs to start. And as you dig deeper, you will find more and more clues which will give you a holistic picture of what really is going on with your marketing efforts. That brings me to the end of today's video. Thank you for watching. I really hope you liked the content that I shared. And if you did, please hit the like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, I suggest you do that now. In my next video, I will introduce a new measure, which is often referred to as the third most important measure for marketers after sales and distribution. Thank you for watching, and see you soon in my next video.